Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and I'm here to talk about the Ubisoft's lineup that they had for E3 2013. And I want to talk about it because it's the lineup that appealed to me the most. I think it's the lineup that had the most games that I was interested in. Which is interesting because I'm not really the biggest fan of Ubisoft games, but what they had for E3 was just like, oh my gosh, that's a game for me, that's a game for me, that's a game for me. They had a lot of games that really appealed to me. So to me, if I had to do this comparison thing where it's just like, who was the best publisher at E3 2013? I hate doing those type of things. But to me personally, my favorite would have to be Ubisoft's. Because Ubisoft had so many variety of games that just appealed to me the most. Rayman Legends looks like a fantastic game. Splinter Cell Blacklist, I'm actually really excited about. Now, I'm kind of cautious about that game because of my experience with Splinter Cell Conviction. I know Splinter Cell Blacklist is kind of a follow-up to Conviction, but I think Blacklist addresses a lot of the things that I felt so horrible about Conviction. Conviction, you can't do non-lethal takedowns. It's all lethal, which was totally contrary to Sam Fisher's mentality and to his abilities, and especially considering that most of the enemies in Conviction are American soldiers or CIA operatives. It's really weird. That's the only time where Sam Fisher's like, the only option I have is to kill them lethally. Like, what the heck? All this time, in the previous Splinter Cell franchises, you have the option to go non-lethal. So for actual terrorists, Sam Fisher is not going to kill anyone. But for actual American soldiers, Sam Fisher is going to kill them and be lethal? Yeah, really bothered me a lot. Also, Sam Fisher didn't have many gadgets or many high-tech technology or abilities. Blacklist really seems to go all out. It's going to have crazy great multiplayer, a lot of stealth options. The level design look a hell of a lot better from what I've seen. And less focus on story. I think that's actually a really good thing for the Splinter Cell franchise. Splinter Cell Conviction tried to focus so much on the storytelling that it really bogged it down. So actually, I'm really excited for Splinter Cell Blacklist, but still kind of cautious for it. Watch Dogs looks fantastic. Definitely my kind of game, just being able to do all that kind of stuff. The Crew, I'm actually really into racing games. I haven't realized that about myself until pretty recently. And for the longest time in my gaming life, I really didn't like racing games all that much, but now I'm into them. And The Crew looks like something pretty, really cool. You're cooperating with other people for different objectives. There is this United States map that you can travel. You start in Detroit, you get to go to New York, to San Diego, and you get to travel all these places, and you are playing with other people. This distinction between single player and multiplayer is just destroyed in this game, as with any other racing game in the next generation consoles, but looks fantastic. The Crew looks like it's going to be something awesome, also because of the customization. You can customize your car to have different equipment, and that different equipment is going to allow you to go to certain areas. So it's like a Metroid racing open world game that is online. So it's kind of an MMO racing game that is like has Metroid elements. Yeah, sign me on. That sounds awesome. Watchdog, of course, looks fantastic. It's just like Assassin's Creed in the future, which is a crazy concept. And there's a lot of variety in the gameplay that was displayed in E3, and this game was really oversaturated. You saw it in the Microsoft conference, you saw it in the Ubisoft conference, you saw it in the Sony conference. It was just everywhere. So it did kind of get like, okay, Watch Dogs again. It did kind of have that feeling, but at the same time, every time I've seen it, it's just like, this game looks awesome. And there's Assassin's Creed 4, which I still have only played two Assassin's Creed games in my life, Assassin's Creed 1 and Assassin's Creed 2. Assassin's Creed 1, it was a good first step. 2, I really, really, really liked 2. I want to get an opportunity to get to play Brotherhood, because I heard that was good. I heard Revelation was a bummer. And 3, I guess there's mixed things about. So, because I haven't played Brotherhood, Revelations, and 3, I'm not that excited about 4 because I haven't played the previous games. But 4 looks interesting, a game where you can be pirates. And then, I think it's always the last game in the Ubisoft conference that just kind of makes people silent and just awed. Because that's what happened. Again, because last year it was Watch Dogs. People were like, what game is this? What's going on? What is this game? and people are tweeting like crazy, like, I want to know the name of this game, I want to know the name of this game. And then it finally came out, and it was like, everyone was just like, wow, that's Game of Show. That's Game of Show. Because it was the one big surprise in that E3 conference. E3 2012 was so full of sequels and franchises, so many sequels, not many original stuff. And finally, this original stuff comes out, Watch Dogs, and it just made everyone nuts. The impact for Tom Clancy's Division wasn't as high, but I think it still got us really surprised. It's like everyone was wondering what game this was. I was actually terrified in the beginning because in the conference, it started talking about how this society that we live in is controlled by automatic systems. And if one of them is closed down or shuts down, in a matter of days, this whole planet goes to shits. And I was just like, holy shit, this is actually realistic and plausible. Terrifying. I was really terrified by the premise of that. And then it actually shows the entire world and has gone to shit. And shows the graphics. What the fuck graphics? Holy crap, this looks amazing. But the gameplay I'm not actually too sold on. It does kind of seem like just a third-person shooter with an MMO online multiplayer component to it. But it is actually an RPG with whole kinds of gadgets and stuff. So that's interesting that there's like this RPG mechanics onto it. Definitely an interesting game to look forward to. I am really hoping that this game has amazing storytelling because it has such an interesting premise. But knowing Ubisoft, that's probably not going to be the case. I don't think this game is going to have a compelling storyline. But one can hope, right? One can hope. But that's the Ubisoft lineup. I'm pretty excited, judging by all those games. Like, those are the games that Ubisoft had that really appealed to me. Is it the strongest lineup? Is it the best lineup? I don't know. That's totally up to personal taste. Me, personally, if I had to be more objective, I'd have to say the best publisher lineup, and I'm going to talk about this in the next video, would probably be EA. I think they had the strongest lineup compared to all the other publishers. Although, I know some people would want to argue Nintendo because all their games look pretty fantastic. All the games they showcased for E3 2013 look awesome, especially considering their 3DS lineup. So, some people would argue that Nintendo has the best lineup, right? But I made another video talking about how Nintendo's lineup is disappointing. It's so weird because it's like, this is the best lineup, but at the same time, it's the most disappointing lineup out of the entire E3 event. Because Nintendo played it so safe. There is nothing surprising in there. Except maybe X. Nothing surprising in that lineup in Nintendo. Nothing. Whereas EA at least has... EA has a lot, actually. EA has a lot. That's why I think EA has the strongest lineup. And I'll be definitely talking about that in the next video. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching.
Cheers.